A certain radioactive material decays in such a way that the mass in kilograms remaining after t years is given by the function m of t equals 120 times e raised to the power of negative 0.018 times t. The general form for an exponential decay model is p of t equals p sub 0 or p naught times e raised to the power of negative kt, where t is the time, k is the decay rate expressed as a decimal, and p sub 0 or p naught is the initial amount. This is almost the same as exponential growth, except for exponential decay, the exponent is negative here, and therefore the function would be decreasing. So going back to our example, our first question is, what is the decay rate expressed as a percentage? Again, the decay rate is k, so here the decay rate would be 0.018 expressed as a decimal. So we have k equals 0.018, but we're asked to express this as a percentage, so we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign, or just move the decimal point to the right two places and add a percent sign. This would be 1.8%. So we can say the decay rate is 1.8% per year. We don't include the negative sign here because we've already stated that it is decay. Next, we want to know what the initial mass is when time t equals 0. Well, we should recognize this is going to be p sub 0, or in this case 120 kilograms. But just to show why, let's go ahead and evaluate this function at t equals 0. So m of 0 would be equal to 120 times e raised to the power of negative 0.018 times 0. So notice here the exponent on e is 0. So we have 120 times e to the 0. Anything to the 0 power is equal to 1, so this is just 120. So the initial mass is 120 kilograms. Now for the last question, how much mass remains after 50 years, round to two decimal places? Well, they're telling us the time t equals 50 years, so we substitute 50 for t, or find the value of m of 50, which would be 120 times e raised to the power of negative 0.018 times 50. And now we'll go to the calculator to get a decimal approximation. We have 120. Now here if we press second ln, it brings up e raised to the power of, and then we have negative 0.018 times 50, close parenthesis, and enter. If we round to two decimal places, notice how the third decimal place is an 8, which means round up. This would be approximately 48.79 kilograms. So after 50 years, approximately 48.79 kilograms remain. Before we go, let's take a look at the graph of our function. Notice how for exponential decay, the function is decreasing. When we found the initial amount, or when t equals 0, we found the function value here at 120. And then when we found the amount remaining after 50 years, we found the function value here at t equals 50. I hope you found this helpful.